In this video, I just want to give you guys some quick information about child themes. If you started doing research about building your site with WordPress, you've probably read something about child themes. There's a lot of posts out there that say you must have a child theme before you start building your website. In this video, I'm going to talk with you about why you probably don't actually need a child theme. I'm Tim from realwebsitehints.com, and it's my mission to help you find the best and easiest ways of building high-quality websites. I focus on helping you find the tools and techniques that allow you to build amazing websites all without having to know how to code. My channel, website, and online courses are all about helping you reach out and connect with your customers, your audience, and your followers by building a great website. And if you're trying to build a customer base, audience, or following, you probably don't also have time to teach yourself how to write code just to build your website. And that brings us to the child theme. The entire purpose of a child theme is to add and modify the code of your WordPress theme. Many of the basic WordPress themes and WordPress frameworks require you to use code to make even simple modifications to the look of your site, like changing the background color of your website, for example. The problem with just modifying the theme code directly is that when there's an update to the theme, that update will overwrite any of the code changes that you made. And you get around this problem by creating a child theme. Essentially, what a child theme does is to tell WordPress that all of the code that you need for this theme are in the parent theme or the main theme, except for the code that you want to modify, and that code is written into the child theme. So updates to the parent theme will not affect the code that you write into the child theme. So if you're comfortable with code and you want to make direct coding changes to your theme, you can do that, but be sure to make a child theme first so that your changes don't get overwritten. But if you're like me and you want to build a website quickly and easily, you should be looking for a page builder theme. A page builder theme gives you all sorts of controls over the look of your website. If you're changing a color setting, a page builder theme will use a color picker, and instead of modifying the code of the theme, the page builder will store that change inside of the database of your website. And storing the changes that you make inside of your database is why you don't actually need a child theme. Since you're using tools that are built into a page builder themes, you aren't actually modifying the code of the theme. So when a page builder theme gets its updates, you don't have to worry about it writing over the styling modifications that you've made because those changes are stored inside of your site's database and not in the theme's files. So I hope you found this video helpful. If you'd like to know what my top recommended page builder themes are, you can head over to realwebsitehints.com/bestwebsite, or you can check out my theme review playlist, and I'll link to both of those in the description below. And if you need help building your website, look for my easy-to-follow online courses on how to build your next website at realwebsitehints.com. For more tips, tricks, and product reviews, be sure to subscribe to my YouTube channel, and thanks for watching.